What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Auto Auction Rebuilds. We are back at Copart for another Copart walk around. Let's jump right into this with a Dooley Ram 3500. By now, it shouldn't be any secret that I'm actually currently trying to sell my 2021 Ram 2500. And of course, I'm out here looking for a workhorse, a tow pig, something that I don't mind using and beating on a little bit. So here we have it. Now, this says it doesn't run. But you know me, I don't ever believe that, guys. I don't ever come out here and think that it doesn't actually run. So, here it is. It is a Ram 3500 Lone Star. It is a 2003, so she's a little bit older than the one that I have. It says limited edition on the side. I don't think that's actually real. It looks like an AutoZone sticker. Now, here's the cool thing. It's a stick shift. Yeah, it's a stick shift. Okay, this has a buy it now of $4,500. $4,500 for a Dooley Cummins. Now, she's a little rough. Uh-oh, hold on. She may be more than a little rough, guys. Uh-oh. Yeah, hold on, what did I just get myself into? Thankfully, I have not hit the buy it now button. Obviously, I wanted to come check it out first. It is rough, guys. It's yeah, you know, but this is just, I thought this is fiberglass. This is like plastic, and this can be replaced. This bolts onto the side of the bed, easily replaced. This side looks to be all right. It's got the big fat exhaust on it. That's important. The tires are pretty bad. You can see that there. The tires are in pretty bad shape. So, I mean, you're already getting into money. It's got hail damage, too. The dashboard is destroyed. Yeah, we could just go on and on with this one, guys. But I'm going to go ahead and pop the hood because for $4,500, let's take a peek. Are we missing anything? Hold on. Well, it looks like everything is here. Boy, those batteries, though. My goodness. Come on, guys. Guys, it looks like everything is here. Okay. Okay, I gotta try it. Let's grab the jump pack. Let's hook it up and let's see what it does or doesn't do. All right, now you guys know as well as I do, these diesels, they drain that battery pack pretty quick. But the fact that that little GB150 is capable of starting diesel engines with no issue, that's pretty impressive to me. I don't see any lights on in here. No, I think we got a bad connection. Nope. Try it again. The e-brake is on. Don't worry, it's not gonna roll anywhere. I got a feeling about this. I can't explain it. I've told you guys this before, but I get these hunches. I really do. I get this like feeling, and usually I'm right. Usually if I got a good feeling about something, I'm right. Not all the time, but generally, that's not it. Generally speaking, if I get a good feeling about something, it's probably pretty decent. It's no accident that like 99% of the cars I pick up from auction turn out to be good runners and drivers. And I can't attribute that to any kind of real skill. It's just kind of like a sixth sense that I have. I know that sounds kind of weird, but I got a feeling about this one. I don't know if it's going to run or not. Obviously, it's listed as a non-runner. Ah. There we go. There we go. But for $4,500 for a Dooley Cummins? Get out of here. Ah. You're killing me, man. You're killing me. Give me a second, guys. Let me clean off these terminals. We'll be right back. All right, we're gonna try it again. See, when I see batteries that are corroded like that, it really makes me wonder, does it not actually run? Or are the battery terminals so corroded that you can't make it run, you know? No, guys, she's still dead as a doornail. This one took some work, guys. to get it coming back to life here, it took some work. So I can understand they hooked a jump pack up to it. Yeah, this thing wasn't gonna run. That don't sound good at all. That sounds very unhealthy. 207,000 miles, that's really not bad. Yeah. Uh-oh. I put a lot of work into this, damn it. Come on now. I had a hunch about this one, I really did, but that does not sound like it's cranking healthy at all. No. Okay. Well, you can't win them all. Damn. I guess I was wrong about this one, guys. Now, I could sit here all day and fight with this thing, but as you can see, I've already lost quite a bit of juice. It's just not gonna crank. It doesn't sound like it's got good compression. Something is, something sounds off down in there. I guess that's why it's $4,500. I don't know, comment below, tell me what you think. Do you think it'd crank better? Maybe we'd have a better chance if we had both booster packs with us. Generally speaking, guys, I can hook that booster pack up, just one, and it'll fire anything up. I have yet to have it not be able to crank up a diesel. So I really don't think that it's the booster pack that's the issue. I really feel like there's something wrong with this one. And that sucks because I was really looking for some cheap tow rig, and this thing honestly would have been perfect. Next on my list, the thumbnail. We got a Firebird. This one is cool because it is a V8. It is a rear wheel drive. It is Knight Rider, right? Okay, you already know it. I mean, it needs paint. It's a repossession. She's got some damn good tires. Would I change the rims? Not a chance. I love the factory wheels. Clear coat peeling. The real question is, would you repaint this black, or would we do what I always do and repaint it retail red or resale red? She's got the T-top. She's got a lot of clear coat burn through. Ooh, is it wrecked? Is it wrecked? Is it wrecked? Oh, whoa, look at them pipes, boy. Holy crap. Wow, okay. This side isn't closed. There's something hanging up on here. Oh man. Oh man, this thing is sitting at $800 right now. Oh, she's rough. She's pretty rough, yeah. Yeah, she's pretty rough. $800 though. It's gonna have that that good old tune port injection. Question is it a V8? I mean, is it a V8? Is it? Yes, it's a V8. The question is it a 350 or is it just a 5.0? We'll find that out here in just a second. What year is it? I mean, it doesn't have any airbags, so it's gotta be like, what, 91, 92? Something like that. Let's put the key in it, see if it... Oh, it's got power. Oh, it's got power. 120,000 miles. She cranks healthy. Come on. Come on, old girl. Yeah. Woo, she's rich. She's rich. Check engine lights on. Let me shut this off. I smell fuel. I smell fuel strong. No, that's raw gas. That's raw gas. That is not like running rich. That is gasoline. You guys may remember a certain Corvette that I had. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Yeah, a certain Corvette I had that caught on fire. This is not something to play with, boys. You see that down there? That is gasoline pouring straight out of the injector or the fuel rail, one of the two. It's leaking everywhere, guys, everywhere. All of the injectors are leaking. I'm shocked that this thing has not burned to the ground. Shocked that it has not burned to the ground. Obviously, we will not make any more attempts at starting it. That's not gonna happen. So this is kind of a pain in the rear to get to the fuel injectors on this. Thankfully, I've done it before a couple times. So, she's got fuel leaking all down here too, everywhere. Absolutely everywhere. I've done this a few times. I know how to get to the fuel rail and everything. It's a pain, man. You got to get this whole upper plenum off. There's these bolts that go crossways, like under here. And you got to have a special tool, which I think I still have from the Corvette. It's a pain to get to, but this one's got to go on a trailer. That's one's got to go on a trailer. It looks like, for the most part, it's stock, other than we got this cheap cold air intake, but it does look like it's got an expensive Optima red top. She does. Yeah, that's a... Well, somebody wasn't screwing around on that battery, were they? Still got the AC compressor. For the little bit it was running, it sounded relatively good, although short on fuel pressure. I'm guaranteeing you she's short on fuel pressure. What do you guys think? Be very gentle with that hood. There we go. I think, personally, for me, I think I would paint it red. I do. I mean, it needs a paint job anyway. I don't think I'd go back with black. Black is so hard to keep clean. It's so hard to keep nice. I think for me, I would just... I think I would just go with retail red. The steering, you know, got... Boy, that smells bad. Wow. Okay. I want to see if we can open that rear hatch. We got some stuff going on over there. I don't know what all that is. Looks like somebody had the AC on. I'm not gonna mess with that. Can we get the hatch to pop there? Maybe not. Do the headlights work? That's another big question. Let's they do. Look at that. They work very well. They work very well. What about the important window? Well, it works, but definitely not the best. That window over there doesn't work at all. It's missing the headliner. The driver's seat's pretty tore up. Horn doesn't work. I didn't get to see if it goes into gear or not either. Dang it. Well, I don't know, guys. What do you think? I think we should at least throw a bid on it. This is all jacked up. Oh, it's just a cover. That's just a cover. Okay, we'll throw that back in there. Yeah, it's got the blacked out taillight look going on there. We need to get the key in there though. This needs to be opened up and I mean, overall though, the body looks really good. The tires are good. The interior is a little rough, but I mean, it's just for me, you know, it's not like a car you're looking to make perfect. It's just a cool little toy that you can go out and play with. I think red would look really, really good. You guys want to throw a bid on it? Let's throw a bid on it. All right, here we go. Let's find it. Where is she? There she is, right there. $800. Buy it now for $3,000. I'm not paying $3,000 for it. That's not going to happen. But I will go ahead and put a bid on it. Let's move this one up a little bit. Let's do $1,800. I'm good with $1,800. All right. Bid placed. We're currently winning it at $850. It's not a pure sale, though, is it? No, it's a minimum bid. Minimum bid, but it's a run and drive. It's a clean title. Minor dents and scratches. 5.7 V8. Yada, yada, yada. Okay. There it is. There it was. Moving on. Moving on down the list. We got a non-runner 2013 Volkswagen Passat with 54,000 miles on the odometer. You guys, I've already said it. You know how I love cars that say they don't run. Especially ones with low miles. Okay, I'm game. It's a diesel. Let's take a look at it. First thing I noticed, she's got good tires. They're Delante DH2. I think we got the same tire here. Looks like she's got a matching set of tires. Nope, these are Firestone. Firestone, a Delante, maybe they're the same brand, hell, I don't know. This is also a Delante. Maybe a Firestone Delante, I don't know. This is also a Delante. So are these Firestone tires? I don't know, guys. Maybe they are. I think these are Firestone tires. I can't tell. I tell you this, so take a look at these brake pads. Somebody's recently done brake pads on it. Look at those suckers. All right, good deal. Well, let's take a look at the interior. Oh, it smells divine. Wow. One of the best smelling cars I have been in a while. Not to mention one of the best looking interiors too. Good night. Yep. Oh, she's got juice too. She's got juice. Now, the problem I have with this one is they want $8,000 for it. That's the only problem I have with this one, is they want $8,000 for a car that supposedly doesn't run. She's got a dead battery. That's fine. I can help you with that. Not a problem. The body looks really good. The interior looks and smells really good. The miles are right. It's a diesel. I mean, what do you guys think? The coolant looks good. Oil looks good, especially for being a diesel. Huh. Okay. Well, we're about to find out. I can't believe they want $8,000 for something that doesn't run. I have no idea what the retail value of this car would even be. I really don't. So don't ask. What does this go to? There's a little plug right there. Ain't plugged up to nothing. Look at that. Huh. Come on now. I don't love these stupid connectors they've got on here. I really don't. But I love these non-runners because you just never know if somebody sabotaged it. You know, somebody pulled a fuse or something or a relay to try to, you know, screw somebody over or to get themselves a better deal. You just don't know. And sometimes taking that risk on a non-runner could be worth it. It can. Well, she really don't run, does she? Let's try it again. Oh. Yeah, it refused to do anything that time. Hold on, she's trying. She's trying. There it is. There it is. There it is. Oh, yeah. Yeah. There it is. Well, she's got some codes too, doesn't she? All right, so let's see what we got on the dash here. We got a steering, which could just be the battery was dead. I feel the wheels working. They seem to be working just fine. We have a traction control, TPMS, and a check engine. She sounds healthy. I mean, it's only got 54,000 miles. I'd probably want to Carfax this and verify that. Okay, she goes backwards. Fault stabilization, she goes forwards. Okay, what about air conditioning? Let's turn on the AC. Audio system works, I'm sure. Yeah, audio system works. Important window. Yes, it does. All right, let's pop the trunk. Now this is an eight, I'm talking quiet because there's some people around me over here, but this is an $8,000 buy it now. I don't see any pre-existing damage to the trunk pan. I always look for that if I remember, and sometimes I don't, but boy, you can smell that diesel. Smell that diesel. Let's go over to the engine. Let's go ahead and shut the booster pack off. She's charging up nicely. Get this out of the way here. Well, you guys tell me what you think. She sounds like she's running great. Canada, eh? I don't smell anything funny. I'm not seeing anything funny going on. Okay. All right. Huh. What do you think, guys? Like, I don't know what this thing is worth. Ugh. I can tell you this, I must not have the AC on. Oh, the AC don't seem to work. You push the button and it doesn't light up. Yeah, it's supposed to be a light there. Okay, well, that sucks. I'll give it a minute. Maybe the light's burned out. See when you push the button, you get the lights. You turn AC off, you get a light. Then you turn AC on, you would think you'd get a light there, but you don't. So I'll let it sit here and just kind of do this for a minute. Okay, you think she'll start back up? Let's try it. Yeah, I mean, started right up. She may have been sitting for so long that she lost her prime for a minute. Diesel's kind of bad about that, but take a look at it, guys. I like this little car. I really do. I really, really do. Okay, well, they want $8,000 for it. Let's pull up the app real quick. Let's see what it's going for. Maybe we'll throw a bid on it. Well, here it is, 2013 Volkswagen Passat. It says primary damage, wait. It's listed as a run. It is listed as a run. I could have swore this was not listed as a run and drive. Mechanical rebuilt title. Oh man. Well, I was all for it until I saw that. I didn't realize that this was listed as a rebuilt title. Not that I have a problem with a rebuilt title. I guess my only problem is they want $8,500 for this. And mechanical damage. What could that be? Could that be that the transmission is bad? It's a DSG transmission, guys. I wouldn't think so at 54,000 miles. Let's take a closer look under the hood and see if we can see anything that may have been previously damaged. So we'll go ahead and pop this hood again. The AC 100% does not work, period. Not at all. That's concerning, especially with that low miles. And the fact that it's mechanically damaged, that is very concerning as well. I have heard people say lots of good things about the DSG transmissions. Ah. Randy, you should have looked a little better there, buddy. You know better than this. You know better than this. Okay. Well, let's take a peek. It doesn't look like anything's been replaced. Everything's got paint over it. All of the Torx and everything have paint over them, except for these two. Nothing looks out of place. Everything looks like it's got a bolt where it's supposed to have one. Everything looks like, well, wait, looky here. Let me zoom you guys in. See that? Ah, chipped paint over here as well. And it's stripped. Yeah, so she's had some front end damage, huh? Can you see it? I can't. It actually looks and feels pretty good. there's a sign for you right there. She's obviously got a leak. This, I don't think this is factory, guys. You think that's factory? That's supposed to just be bouncing around under there like that? Take a look under here. You can see a little damage right there. You see that? Broken plastics. Yes, sir. That right there is misaligned. Right there. Yeah, that was poorly done. Okay, I get it now. I get it. I don't know what the mechanical damage is on this. I don't. Do I feel like taking an $8,500 risk? No, not really, guys. Look at this right here. 54,000 miles, come on now, nah. As you can see, it was listed as a non-runner. I know it was. I remember it being a non-runner, and I wanted to come check it out because I couldn't believe that 54,000 miles and it wouldn't run. Oh, looky here. I wonder what's going on there. Okay, well, Here's the deal, guys. This thing might be worth $8,500 all day long. It really might. I'm just going to tell you right now, for me and where I'm sitting right now, I'm not willing to pay $8,500 for this car. I don't want to put a bid on it, so we're going to move on. So I wasn't going to say anything to you guys yet. My fiance is looking for a new car. That's right. Something that she could have for herself that she's going to enjoy. And I know she drives the Ram, but the truth is she doesn't really care for the Ram all that much because it's so dang big. It's hard for her to park and maneuver that dang thing, and I don't blame her one bit. So since I have been the one to pick out all of our cars the whole time we've been together, I told her it's time for her to pick something out. And I told her she's absolutely welcome to pick out anything as good, maybe even a little bit better, a little newer, maybe a little more expensive than what I'm buying, because she deserves it. There's no reason my woman shouldn't have something at least equally as good as what I'm riding around in. So I saw this and I showed it to her and she loved it. She wants this. Like, she really wants this. It is street legal. It's tagged. Boom. You could drive this on the road. She said she'd drive it. Yeah. It says it doesn't run, but I'm pretty sure I get this running. I am certain I can get this running. Let me tell you guys one more thing. If you think I'm serious, you think my old lady would be okay with me. Oh, dude, she would slap the dog out of me if I brought this home and said, here you go, babe. I got you a new car today. No, this isn't it. I'm screwing with you. The real vehicle, not for her, not for her, but the real, not that either. Bio mold, yeah. The real vehicle I'm looking at is this one right here. So this is a non-runner again. Lots of non-runners today, guys. The secret is non-runners generally go cheap. Who would have known, right? My goodness. Sorry, guys. I'm getting excited. It's almost 3 o'clock. It's like 2:10, and at 3 o'clock, my Tesla gets delivered, and I'm like super stoked and excited about this. I don't see the prop rod. I'm not sure where the heck the prop rod even is. If it's on here, I'm just totally missing it. It looks like it goes up here, and it looks like it would have gone right there. Oh, there it is. I see it. Good. It's missing a piece. Okay, well, we'll throw it right here, and I'll just kind of hold on, guys. Dag nabbit. Anyway, here it is. What is going on with that belt? Hold on. Does something look wrong with that belt there, guys? Yeah, I'm thinking somebody put the wrong belt on it. That or the wrong pulley for the power steering pump. There's an extra groove there. I don't think there's supposed to be. Let's check the oil. I have a hard time believing this thing doesn't run. Yeah, that oil looks a little... That's milkshake. That is milkshake. Damn. We are striking out today, guys. This is not like me. This is not like me. We are really striking out over here at the auction today. So I'm gonna throw a jump on. I'm gonna see what it does. Look, blown head gaskets. I'm gonna let you guys in on a little secret. And yeah, it's a shade tree trick, and some of you are gonna say, oh, you're wrong for this, but I'm here to tell you, I swear by Blue Devil, guys. I mean, I really do. I really do. I can't tell you how many times when I was a little bit younger I want y'all to remember something, okay? I didn't start getting my stuff together until I was in my mid-20s, mid to late 20s, before I finally started getting my life together. So it wasn't as long ago as you might think that I had some beater mobile that I had to drive around in. I was thankful to have it because it sure as hell beat nothing. So I bought cars back in the day with blown head gaskets all day long. And you know what? I learned that, somebody's out there firing up that car. They're gonna catch it on fire. They're gonna catch it on fire. It wasn't me, you hear it. Somebody's out there screwing with it right now. I'm telling you, you can't not smell that gasoline, guys. You cannot ignore the smell of that gasoline. Let's see if it runs. Yeah, she's got low compression. She does. That doesn't mean she won't run. You just gotta play with them a little bit. I'm kind of the king of head gaskets, man. There she goes. You just gotta kind of keep on them. Feather the pedal a little bit. Yeah. She's trying. Yeah, this one may be a no-go, but Blue Devil, man, it is safe. Oh, hold on. Look at this. What is this? You gotta be kidding me. Radiator, oh, dude. Okay. So it had a coolant leak, and instead of replacing the radiator, somebody dumped stop leak in it. Come on. Okay. Nah, I'm gonna say no on this. It's cranking too slow. You can hear the uneven compression. Blue Devil does work miracles though, guys. I'm telling you, boy, we about killed the booster pack too, dagnabbit. Now, I'm not recommending that you go out and you throw some Blue Devil in a car and then sell it to somebody. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, you know, if you're in a bind and you need something on the cheap and you need it quick, and you got a head gasket issue, no shame in throwing Blue Devil in there, guys. There's no shame at all. Throw that Blue Devil in there and hopefully get you down the road for a while longer. I've had great success with it. Unfortunately, on this one, I don't think it's going to do much good on this one, guys. So I'm going to move on to a little BMW. Let's see if we can get it to run. Well, it doesn't look like that Firebird's on fire yet. Firebird. Boy, that car really is a fire waiting to happen. Last on my list, this is a buy it now for $1,100, man. It's a, you know, it's a clean little old BMW. It's a, looks like a little 3 Series. I don't know what year. We'll find out here. We'll take a quick peek. Let's see, ooh, this thing has seen better days. Oh boy, she has. This is a 5 of 04, so this is an 04 BMW, probably a 325, 328i. Surely it's not a 330 or 335, right? Oh, it's a 330. It's a 330. It's not an X drive, but that's okay. It's rear wheel drive. All right. I kind of like those. What kind of wheels are those? Bairn wheels? I like them. I do. Tell me what you guys think. What do you think of those rims, guys? Okay. So far, the body looks pretty good. I mean, it's, you know, it's she's a little beat up. She's a little beat up, but not too bad. It's going to be a CDS car. Means it belongs to a dealer, which, you know, I'm a little leery of. If a dealer is done with it, I mean, yeah. That's just my philosophy, okay? That's my personal belief. That's my opinion, not fact. But, you know, it's my belief that when a dealer is done with a car, generally speaking, the car is done. You got a Love Buds lighter. I don't know. There's the sunroof piece. Ow, that hurts. That's got some sharp crap under it. What do we got here? Remote function button. Those some damn scissors. Are you kidding? Look at these blades, guys. Holy crap. There's some razor blades right here. Look at this. Woo. Wow, okay. Let's put that back in so nobody ends up getting hurt. Got some hooped earrings. We got a Apple charger. There's something at the door here. Like a key, I guess. Now, I don't even know what that is, to be honest with you. This thing is rough, guys. Listed, as I said earlier, non-runner. No odometer with OBD. I don't know what that means. No odometer with OBD. Does that mean somebody, like, you gotta have this OBD port closed. That's important to know. The car knows if the OBD port is open. And, you know, sometimes the car doesn't care for that very much. Okay. Well, let's pop the hood, guys. Let's pop the hood and let's see if we can get lucky. I would probably give $1,100 for this. I would probably go ahead and buy it now if we can get it running. What do you think? Cooling system? I'm going to throw a guess out there. Cooling system issues, right? So somebody's been under here and it looks like the lid is gone for the coils. These coils are great, man. They've got a little notch on them. You just flip it up, pull them off, lock them down. It's that simple. Looks like everything is plugged in. We're going to jump start it from right there. First thing I'm going to do is check the cooling system, because I'm telling you guys, these cars are not that bad. Yeah, nope, no coolant. You guys probably won't be able to see down in there, but there's nothing in there at all. Saw that coming. These damn BMWs and their cooling system. I've had so many people. I have had so many people tell me, I have owned BMWs all my life. I've never had a problem with the cooling system. There's supposed to be a shroud thing that goes over here too. That's missing. So somebody's been in here. Somebody's been in here. I'm going to guess that it probably really doesn't run. The cooling systems just seem to be so brittle on these cars. It's really sad. I think you'd see a lot more of them on the road today if they were just made a little bit better. A little bit stronger. But, you know, unfortunately, when things like that go wrong, but what ends up happening is you get people that don't know how to work on them, or you get people that, you know, can't afford to have them repaired when they break, but they want a nice car, and you can't blame them for that, guys. You can't blame people for wanting to have something nice. You know, it's just, unfortunately, we all at some point feel like we gotta fit in with the Joneses, you know what I mean? Like, you've got to have that particular car so that you fit in with people around you. And the sad truth is like when you're buying these, especially used, especially without a warranty or a service contract, guys, oh, you know, you end up with something as simple as a broken radiator. And whereas on a GM car, you know, an old GM car, it might be $80, $90. But you find out for these, like $200. So people end up doing the right thing and throwing stop leak in them, not fixing them, overheating them, and eventually blowing them up. We got 178,000 miles. It's cranking. Honestly, the compression to me doesn't sound bad. It's got fuel. It sounds like it's cranking, but it's either lacking spark or it's lacking fuel. Now I think I might actually hear it trying to fire. Nah. I don't know, guys. What do you think? I'm gonna cycle the key a couple times in hopes that if maybe the fuel pump is weak, you know, maybe we can build up a little extra pressure just cycling it on and off a few times. Oh, that beeping is annoying. Someone had just changed the oil in it though. Nah. Okay. Someone had just changed the oil in it though. Look at that. Valvoline. Do again 12/28/21 at 183.9. So it was running. It was running not that long ago. Makes you wonder what happened. And I do see stuff splattered all over here. And I noticed the coil covers are missing. So are we lacking spark? Are we lacking fuel? I mean, you can find out if it's fuel pretty quick. There's a Schrader valve right here. And you're gonna wanna stand back when you do this, and you're gonna wanna turn the power off, of course, disconnect it and everything like that. It just take you a nice little, find something on the ground here, maybe a little stick or maybe even a tiny rock. You can just kinda step back, depress the Schrader valve. I'm pretty sure I pushed it, guys. Let's try this. Ah, we got gas. Okay, so she's got fuel pressure. All right. So you know she's getting gas. You know she's getting air. The question is, why doesn't it run? Could it be low compression? Yeah, possibly. Possibly. It doesn't have coolant in it. It can have a blown head gasket. Honestly, hard to say. Is this something that I really want to take a risk on? I don't know. At $1,100, I guess it's not that bad of a deal. The wheels look nice. I think the body looks decent. Comment below. Tell me what you think, guys. I'll take it under consideration. I'm not going to bid on this one in this video. Like, deep down, I don't feel like it's a good one. I don't feel like this is one that I want to mess with. I don't. But damn, if we got it running, this would be a great little car. Then again, it's got 180,000 miles on it, and it's kind of, you know, it looks like it's been beat to hell. So for now, I'm going to walk away from this one, guys. But definitely comment below. Let me know if you're interested in seeing it on the channel. I can always throw a bid on it or hit the buy it now button. And with that, we're done. This is a short video. I know. I'm crossing my fingers. I think the car that I want the most, and I'm hoping that you guys want to see it the most, is the Firebird. I really want that Firebird. I think you get that fuel leak all sorted out. I think you have a nice little car there, man. Get the fuel leak sorted. Get it a quick paint job. Nice retail red. She'd probably be good to go, guys. And I'm really interested in that car. I hope we win it. I think my biggest concern is with it leaking so much fuel is that somebody's going to come out here and play around with it. I'll be honest with you. As soon as I started it, I told you guys I smelled it. I thought it was just running rich. But it only took me a few seconds to really come to and be like, wait a minute. That's raw fuel and shut her down. And you got other people come out here and they start firing that car up and they're revving on it and everything. You're dumping fuel all over the engine, and the engine's getting hotter and hotter as you're doing it. I hope that we don't end up let's not jinx it. Couldn't you see it? We win the bid, we come to pick it up, and when we get here, it's burnt down. Right? And it's like, no, the car is yours. And I'm going to be sitting there going, uh-uh. No, I bid on that car before it was burnt to a crisp. I want it not burnt down. But we'll see what happens, though, guys. I am going to get out of here because in about 20 minutes, I've got a Tesla Model 3 Performance being delivered to my front door. Yes, we're doing a video. I bought it from Carvana. I think I got it for a really good price, considering today's market. But you guys will have to be the judge of that. So stay tuned. We're going to have that coming. Later in the week, we're also going to be working on the Audi A6 Avant. I can't wait to get the exhaust patched up on it, be able to put the car back together, clean it up, and probably go ahead and send that one down the road as well. We got a lot happening, guys. Don't forget, we got some other auction walkarounds coming later in the week. Stay tuned for all that. If you enjoyed the video, hit the thumbs up button. Let me know you enjoyed the content. If you didn't, well, go ahead and hit the thumbs down button. Drop those comments down below. Follow me on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, Auto Auction Rebuilds with an S. And until next time, stay safe out there, everybody. I look forward to seeing you all again very soon in the next one.